So, what is rice? You tell me what rice is. Because
I don't know what rice is. What is a rice?
A race of people. What is rice?
I don't know.
So you tell me what you think rice is. I've got some papers here. Dictionary. Any of the traditional divisions of humankind. Traditional? Communist being Caucasian. Distinctive, universal, physical. Characteristics no longer in technical use. So, there is no more race. Or races. It says it. No more longer in use. B. Arbitrary classification of modern human beings. So it's like what someone thinks off the top of their heads. So is arbitrary good enough for a justice system to be based on? This is what it is. Arbitrary classification of modern humans. And people are getting tried and done and justified end up in criminal courts because of arbitrary. We need it defined what race is, so that if someone can get done for race, they know that they are of one race and the other person is of another race. Now, what it is you're supposed to think of it in your own head. I think I am this, and I think the other person is that, and they don't know. You know, they must look at the genetics. I think this and I think that. Please sort them out because I think they was biased against me because of race. And then they put the race label on it. But nobody knows what race is. It's if you send a scientist off, right, to find out the term, you go back to his history books to look it up. It's all about the 17th century or something, I don't know. It's ancient history. Now, when it comes to modern science and global warming, oh yeah, all over the latest science, the latest, you know, deprecations. Have the government done this on race? No. They're back here, they've got their feet firmly planted in the 17th century. We what think. But they're worse than that. Because that was like Caucasian race, and that meant Asians and North African. So that can't be that, can it? So what you have here is a government making up what they think, or arbitrarily what everyone else thinks, is something called race. They're making it up. They've reinvented the term race. But it's even worse than that, because they're more like racist and bigoted and prejudiced than even those antique terms. Because they've got, it just means dark skin, light skin versus dark. That's even more racist than the Caucasian race term. So, what we need is for the government, if there's a charge for race, there has to be such a thing as a race, right? For someone to be something that of the other person's race, it has to be defined. There has to be a government booklet called you are this race and they are this race, and define it. There has to be that. Otherwise it's going to be like, it's just like someone's being prejudiced. They're making people prejudiced. They're saying, oh look, and it's the worst sort as well. It's not on any scientific level. Because you've seen these scientific books, they go like, it's all like blended from a bit of the Britain, it goes, those sort of genetic markers, and it blends across the world like that. You've seen those genetic markers, they blend across, right? So where are these race barriers? They're invented by the government. The government is being biased and racist, really, by making people different like this. And caste system. The government has invented a caste system that sounds like you're a bit darker, you're a bit lighter, like that. The government has reinvented the caste system, the racist caste system. So what is race really? It's nothing, it doesn't exist. It's minimal differences in amounts of melanin, nose shapes. It's like that nose is a bit bigger, that nose is a bit smaller, So it's really about like almost sizeism, you know, or you could be that taller, you're that shorter. It's like the worst prejudice possible, and it's government sanctioned. It's like saying, oh, I didn't get that job because that person's got a smaller nose, and he's got a bigger nose, or he's got a different coloured hair, you got ginger hair, and I've got white hair. It's like it's on that level. So it's all about minute characteristics, but these are like, they're given the term race, and it's supposed to mean something special, and it doesn't mean anything, because it doesn't exist. So, what is my race? I haven't got one. The government says, I'm a white man in Britain, in England, and I haven't got a race. I don't belong to a race. If there was a sort of a race I had, I suppose it would be like in the past, they'd say, Caucasian, and that means like the whole of Europe and beyond, really. So the government hasn't defined me as having any race. I haven't a race. There is no government booklet defining I've got a race. It will say in the most prejudiced terms, if any criminal actions come up, that I have a lighter skin colour than someone else. Look at me, I'm albino, for Christ's sake. I'm lighter than everybody. Does it put me in a different race from everybody else because I've got a different skin colour? Might be in my race apart, eh? So that's odd. I haven't got a race. The government of this country has determined that I haven't got a race, and yet I could be racist. So someone else could have a race, but I haven't got a race. So how they can say that you're racist, I don't know. Perhaps I'm a rabbit. There's someone else with a race, they're a human race, and I'm a rabbit. How you can have that as races, I don't know. It's like rabbit or man. I mean, what is that about? I mean, so that's odd. So I'm waiting for a human race definition book from the government. Thank you very much. Tell me what I am.